we started, it was actually minimum people in terms of membership. The membership have grown tremendously. Also, in terms of engagement, there have been a lot of space, and we have the enough skills and capacity to engage. We can go and demand and even seek and even visit the governor and say, you've just come and visit, what do you have for? Informal settlement, they say, okay, we have this street lighting program, and there's a lot of dissenting voices on the issue of land. Can you help me? We have this kind of a police post that will be constructing a lender. We proposed it. And also the will of the people to engage them by themselves, the people's led advocacy is there. So from that kind of a being passive, being unable to speak, people are now able to speak. They're able to express themselves without any fear. The issues that Federation now begin to deal with came later in 2005.
Mm-hmm.
That's the moment that we are now to open up to other informal settlements,
mm-hmm.
to federate community groups, another informal settlement into saving groups.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, as we just knew Federation as a savings and loaning group, not mm-hmm. even other solutions.
Mm-hmm.
So in 2005 is when we started what is called citywide enumeration. All the informal settlements were enumerated under the Cities Without Slums program, the UN Habitat and the SDI program. So from then is that now we're still seeing there's a huge gap in terms of services, in terms of infrastructure. So from that point, we started advocating for services. We started advocating for inclusivity. We started advocating for voice and space for the people, because you'll find like there are issues like participation in the governance, like disenfranchising people to participate in their own affairs. So issues that were there was issues of sanitation was very key. Because you'll find like like in my place, Nyalenda, where there's a section called Nyalenda A. That place was a place with a high water table, and there wasn't a sewer line. That area, and there used to be a lot of bilharzia, cholera in that area, and so forth. We wrote to municipal council of Kisumu. We told the municipal council of Kisumu that there is a time bomb. We started advocating for the trunking of the sewer line up to that places, and also for the beginning of the adoption of the new technologies for the toilets. There was no land for any kind of public facility, so it didn't pick up very well. But currently, at least there are a lot of drainage. There's a lot of control on construction of pit-track drains, and also there are a lot of plans to construct sewer tracks. The other thing also we were dealing with was about the loaning, because Kisumu was a place whereby there was influx of microcredit institutions that would loan women 10,000 and they take your almost electronics in the house as collaterals. If you fail to pay even once, all your collateral are confiscated and they're disposed to settle the loan. And to be very bad, like you'll find like my mom was a victim at one point. A loan balance of 2,000 shillings, our black and white great world TV was gone. Our battery, car battery that was new was gone. Our area, not by that time, those things were used to be expensive and prestige at the same time. They were gone because of a 2,000 shillings loan balance. We need flexible loan, social loan, whereby everyone could understand, I don't have today. The Federation is currently dealing with enhancing the micro opportunities, the micro results that we are actually says through the opportunities to have people organized to do what is called the social savings, to have people organized to demand for services, to have people organized to engage in policy. There's high level of participation of federation in county level in terms of party and any policy formulations processes. There's also high presence of federation in terms of partnership for development, consultations and so forth. And the membership, and the membership is also huge. And that's also one thing that you can commend as an opportunity and a resource for Federation in Kisumu County. Probably we have 36 groups, and these groups have got different membership, meaning that Federation does not lock anybody out. So you could probably have more than 5,000 members in Kisumu County.
Mm-hmm.